If you're a conservationist or anyone else interested in whether or not actions are effective, there's a problem in assessing the effectiveness of actions. This is called regression to the mean. And this is perhaps best illustrated by thinking about speed cameras. Speed cameras are introduced where there's a flurry of accidents. And many studies have shown that the accident rate declines once speed cameras have been introduced. And there can be two main reasons for this. One reason is that drivers just become safer, and so the accident rate goes down. And that indisputably seems to be true. The second is that there might be a flurry of accidents by chance, and then afterwards it goes back to the usual rate, and so there's a decline which has nothing to do with the speed cameras. And this is called regression to the mean. It's regressing to the average value, to the mean. So why am I talking about this in a conservation video? As a conservationist, there could be all sorts of problems. It could be for the species that you care about, there's a sudden flurry of deaths or individuals failing to breed. It could be that there's a whole series of accidents. Perhaps animals get run over, fly into windows, get trapped in fishing nets. It could be there's a problem with the public. Perhaps there's vandalism at your facilities. And so you might carry out an action and then think it's successful, but that success is actually just due to regression to the mean. So what do you do about this? Well, there are three possible actions as I see it. Firstly, you can just decide that what you're doing is worthwhile and you're just going to do it anyway. And hopefully you have the integrity not to attribute any apparent decline due to the action and say it could just be regression to the mean. Secondly, what they do for speed cameras is that they look at the rate where the problem's identified, and then often there's a gap between that and the speed cameras being introduced. And if you look at the time in the middle, it turns out that the accident rate is usually quite a lot lower, so showing regression to the mean is important, but it's not as low as it is after the speed cameras are introduced, showing that the speed cameras do have a genuine effect. And then the third thing you might do is carry out an experimental test. Compare in different sites, different times, whether or not this action makes a real difference. So I guess the important lesson is that practitioners and decision makers have to understand regression to the mean so they can decide whether or not the policies they're carried out are actually genuinely right or based on a statistical artifact.